Childbirth is one of the most beautiful moments in life. We all hope that newborns are healthy and can start to discover the world. Sometimes, however, not everything is alright. When Mary was born, her parents were joyful. They could not wait for their daughter. Her birth was not complicated and she seems to develop normally. But over the next weeks, Mary started to develop some weird symptoms. Her eyes seemed to move involuntarily and she didn't gaze at her parents. The whole family became worried and so they went to the hospital. Upon arrival, the doctor scanned her eyes, but they couldn't determine what was going wrong. Only when a specialist conducted further tests a few weeks later, it became clear. Mary suffered from Leber, congenital amaurosis, or LCA. LCA is caused by genetic changes or mutations leading to an impaired visual system. This diagnosis meant that Mary would become permanently blind. Unfortunately, many genetic disorders such as LCA cannot be cured. However, some scientists try to change that. Last month, a new study has shown that many genetic eye diseases might be cured using optogenetics and gene therapy. And with that, my name is Gunnar Steinek and today we'll discuss gene therapy and how we might be able to cure blindness. So our goal today is to find cures for genetic disorders. Sounds easy enough, right? No, but we'll talk about gene therapy, a branch of research which in my opinion might revolutionize modern medicine. So we'll first discuss how genetic disorders work and then how we might cure them. Genetic disorders are diseases which are caused by defects in at least one gene. These genetic changes are often called mutations and they are inherited by our parents. When an egg cell is fertilized by sperm, the DNA of the mother is combined with the DNA of the father. Most of the times this works smoothly and normal development kicks in. Sometimes, however, we inherit mutations in specific genes. And in very rare cases, both parents give us mutations in the same gene and that might lead to a genetic disorder. Of course, in reality it's a bit different than that. You might remember from school that we sometimes only need one mutation in order to become sick, but we just keep it like that for today. The girl we have seen in the beginning of this video suffered from Leber congenital amaurosis, or LCA. LCA is a rare genetic disease which occurs in 1 out of 40,000 newborns. And in this case, mutations in over 22 genes have been associated with the disease. As we've seen in Mary's case, LCA primarily affects the eyes. If light passes through our eyes, it is focused by a lens. The light then hits the back of the eye, which is called the retina. The retina is responsible for the detection of light as it contains rods and cone cells. Rods and cone cells are special types of cells which are able to convert light into electrical impulses. These impulses are then processed by the brain. And here is also where Mary's genetic mutations has its effects. In order to work properly, rods and cone cells need photoreceptors from the retinal pigment epithelium. And in many LCA cases, the production of photoreceptors does not work. And this means that rods and cone cells which give us our sight do not receive vital molecules and they do not work properly anymore. So light cannot be detected and this leads to permanent blindness. The thing about genetic disorders is that often only one gene does not work and the rest does. So in these cases, you can compare our body to a complex machinery with hundreds of components. The whole device only works if every component is in the right place. If one gear is broken, the whole machine stops. But it also means that if we replace the one broken gear, then everything should work again. And this is the main principle of gene therapy. In gene therapy, we want to provide cells with an intact version of a mutated gene. So in the case of LCA, we would identify which gene doesn't work and then try to get an intact version into the retinal pigment epithelium. The cells would then start to make photoreceptors again, which would be given to rods and cone cells, and then the patient could be cured. Sounds easy? It's difficult. There are many questions we have to address until gene therapy really works. So here are three major questions. Number one, how do we supply the gene? We cannot inject a naked gene alone as it would be rapidly destroyed by the body. So instead, we pack our gene into a so-called vehicle. Vehicles contain non-viral or viral parts and they encompass the DNA. In this manner, the DNA is protected and we can at the same time try to get it into cells. Question number two, how do we deliver the gene? Our goal is to get a gene into the right cells. This can be very difficult, Our bodies contain billions of cells, and most of them do not like to take up DNA. But in the case of LCA and other eye diseases, we are actually quite lucky, because we can directly inject the vehicle and the gene into the retinal pigment epithelium. So our vehicle does not need to travel through the whole body in order to find the cells we want to target, but instead it's directly injected into the right place. And the final and very important question is safety. How can we ensure that gene therapy is safe? This has been a major concern in gene therapy. We want to inject the gene to be active throughout the rest of the patient's life. So we could try to make it part of the patient's DNA or keep it as a small extra chromosome. But at the same time, we want to be very careful as our injected DNA could be harmful for the patient's DNA. If, for example, we make a gene therapy where other genes of the patients are destroyed, then they might develop cancer. We've covered how cancer forms in this video, but in very early gene therapies there have been cases where that actually happened. So these are the three main questions where most active research is being conducted. And in the past years there have been quite a few successes. A few clinical studies have successfully improved the eyesight of LCA patients which carry disruptions in the gene RPE65. RPE65 is one of the over 20 genes which have been associated with LCA. In a phase 1 clinical trial, for example, an intact version of RPE65 was packed into a vehicle and then injected into one eye of the patients respectively. It was then shown that the sight of 6 patients slightly improved over time. These effects lasted for over 2 years, but I want to point out that the improvements quite varied a lot between patients, and some additional patients didn't show any improvements. So in this case, the treatment seemed to have different efficiencies depending on the patient. So you might not think, okay, cool, Clemens, nice, so gene therapy seems to work, so why isn't this video ending right now? Well, I'd like to spend time with you. But there is also one last twist. We've already said that not only one gene can make a genetic disorder. For example, in the case of LCA, over 20 separate genes can make the disease. So in order to cure LCA, we do not need one, but over 20 different gene therapies. And that means that we have to conduct dozens of clinical trials and we have to enroll many different patients, and this is not very feasible. So, and with that, we come to a very recent study. You see, there is one shortcut. And this shortcut might help us to develop a treatment for all the different gene defects which can make an eye disease. So welcome to the crazy world of optogenetics, a technique which might give us superhuman-like abilities. Optogenetics is a method where we use light to control nerve cells or neurons. Optogenetics works similar to the gene therapies we've already covered. But instead of bringing in an intact version of a mutated gene, we bring in a protein called crimson R. The special thing about crimson R is that it is a light-sensitive protein, meaning that it opens up when you shine light on it. If we import crimson R into the neurons of the retina and then apply specific light, the protein opens up and activates neurons. So instead of getting feedback from rods and cone cells, neurons can be activated themselves if we apply special light. A few weeks ago, gene therapy was combined with optogenetics to partially restore sight in a 50-year-old blind patient. In this case, the patient suffered from retinitis pigmentosa, another genetic eye disease. Similar to conventional gene therapies, crimson R was packed into a vehicle and then injected into one eye. Over the next 1.5 years, the eye was regularly scanned to see if there's any inflammation. It seemed that the therapy was well tolerated, and so first tests could start. The patient put on light-stimulating goggles. These goggles were made to constantly scan the surroundings and emit a special light into the eyes once objects are registered. So depending on the environment, parts of the goggles are activated and the patient gains sight. In fact, the patient was able to grab specific objects at the desk. Of course, this technique does not completely give the patient his sight back. You have to think that we only have one kind of signal. So we can compare that to seeing ghostly shadows rather than seeing all colors of a flower bed. So a lot of stuff needs to be done, but the method itself is revolutionary. And in a few decades, this kind of technology might even lead to superhuman-like abilities. You see, once this method becomes more and more sophisticated, there might be a certain point where we can see more details than normal persons. But for now, what do you think? If this technique is really established one day, would you maybe consider it in order to gain superhuman-like abilities? Let me know in the comment section. Feel free to subscribe and hit the bell button if you want to know what's going on in the world of science. And with that, I'll see ya. Are you always tired? Maybe your biological clock doesn't work. Click here to find out more. If you want to know why we should have cancer all the time, you might like this video here.